Alrighty. Open the venser, huh? Well, it's either Venser or Punisher. Think those are the only two choices here. Venser is a little bit awkward to first pick, but also not awkward to first pick. Okay, I'm willing to first pick this. Yeah, taking a blue-black card, I know. Are we taking the Punisher? We could take Batter Fist here. We might still take Batter Fist anyways. I'm not going to take Titan second. Back-to-back gliders here as well. Mantis is nice. Okay. A lot of good cards here. I think I'm gonna go with the Slash over the Halberd. Strider. Watcher, attendant. Think this makes the most sense. Probably gonna keep taking red. Yeah, getting punished for not taking the Punisher, but I think it made sense. Power level of the Venser is obviously high. It's just blue black, that's all. Seen a bunch of these Hive Masters go around. Lookout's okay. Could also just take Troll. Yeah, I think I'd rather take Troll here. I mean, we are seeing some black and blue stuff go around, but sideboard Twilight or take the Rat? Guess I'd rather have sideboard Twilight. I mean, if I pick up enough. Equipment, we can also just play that in our main. Yeah, man, actually a lot of good black going around for some possible business there. Almost like taking the Charge of Mites, but we've seen a ton of these stinging Hive Masters now. Huh. Okay. Man, is this going to be a hard pivot? This is going to be so weird. Because we passed a lot of decent black already. Not really much blue. There was like an experimental augury. Okay. Well, Maybe we can wheel some stuff. The augury is the biggest loss because we really need the proliferation, but we also saw a rat. See, I'm just going to take engraver here over head cleaver, I'm pretty sure. Red is still better, but this is just some kind of bait. Yeah, I'm taking engraver. Helm's fine if we end up in red-white. See, there's another pack of blue-black stuff. I mean, the Whispers are fantastic with Vencers if we ended up there, but the Hive Master, I think, is just better. Interesting. Very interesting. Gems or sideboard duress? You know he's serious if he's taking the sideboard duress over 40 gems. Especially after yesterday's spew. Shouldred? One time? Dragonwing glider. That's not bad. Okay. I don't think it's like a bomb, but it's very good. Yeah, maybe it is bomby. 4/4 flying haste for 5 that re-equips. Another troll, second mantis we've seen. Like, what happens if I get past something like a Blue Sun's Twilight? Probably just have to take it. Well, it's not a Blue Sun's Twilight, it's a Conduit, which I don't think we're going to be taking. Glare for the black or Piggy for the green. Piggy's kind of insane, but we haven't really seen much green. The glare's pretty good here. Now, I could probably expect to see a decent bit of green this pack, but black was super open from what we saw, so I'm going to take the glare. Immobilizer versus second fist. Is red-black the way I'm gonna go? Maybe I get a bunch of Charforgers. Some good red cards here. Alright, maybe double Vencers. A dream. Charge or Rabble? I'm going to take the charge over to Rabble. Fuseling. Fuseling versus green card, or maybe Helm. Fuseling's okay with some of these cards. Grimnark's fine if I don't want to take another two drop. Slinger is safer. Because again, we might not necessarily be playing black. A lot of Watchers going around, but I don't think we were supposed to take those. Just no playables at all for us. Rebuke's all right. Another Helm. Yeah, these packs are dry. Sheesh. Not a Koth. Koth would be pretty great here. Yeah, I guess we're taking the slash. It's good. Wouldn't mind a second Strider, but I think I'm going to go with Edifice here instead. Could also take Against All Odds and still be white. My black's not all that great. Two Gold Warden's Helms and Against All Odds is not bad. Like I said, I'm not really locked into black by any means. Yay, 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 dude. Another Strider, I guess. This has been a weird draft. I don't know what I was supposed to be drafting. I mean, this pack is just like all Esper, so it's hard to say. Oddly, I think I just need to take a 3-mana 2/2 flyer. Holds our equipment well, if nothing else. Alright, I mean, now we're starting to see something. We would take a bunch of these cards. I guess I go with Char. I mean, even Paladin's just good. Returns any of the threes. I don't mind Testament Bearer, though, for curve purposes. I think it's a good enough card anyways. Scamp's decent. Hive Master, Blazing, all decent. We have two fists for the Scamp as well, so that's a little bit better. Splitter's nice on Scamp. Yeah, I'll take the cheaper creature. I don't think we're going to be playing Feed. I have an Inquiry as well. I will probably run Edict. Two duresses in my side already, so we don't need third. Talk about this fight for centuries. Actually, Whispers was pretty nice there too. Oh, this bugged out. Oh, I want the Whispers. Okay, it auto-selected it, I think. What the heck, that was weird. Ooh, Grimnarch too. Quality. I think the Whispers is going to be a sideboard starter, though. I think I'm gonna run the card draw over the Fuseling. 3 mana, draw 2, lose 2, or 4 mana, draw 3, lose 3. I think I actually have to go for the draw 4, draw 3. Okay, this actually looks pretty good. Nine mountains, by the way. Oh, we're playing against blue-green. Maybe that gives me some hope. Or it means their deck's insane. I mean, this five-card hand can win. Like a contaminated bloater or whatever. Same thing. They must have, like, Ruthless Predations and stuff in their hand if they didn't block there. No, or not. Can't complain on a mulligan to 5 and win. That's for sure. Looks like our Hexgold Slashes are going to be amazing versus them. They're probably green-white poison with the blue splash, maybe for like the Tainted Observers and stuff. I didn't see any reason to bring in Whispers of the Dross. I like Duress on the draw, oddly. Cut the scamp for it. Everything they played had 3 or more toughness that we saw. Not that they won't have smaller creatures, but they did in that game. Jesus. I'm gonna keep that. This hand is a little bit weak versus mass creatures, but I don't think on the draw you mulligan this. On the play, I would. All right. Well, that's annoying. But we can kill the first two. I need to not draw lands for a little bit. Please don't rip a plains. Okay, that's fine. That is a plains, but... Well, no, it's not fine. That's annoying. I'm gonna need to draw a slash for that, the Tyranax. It's not a slash. I'm gonna take five here and three poison. With Volt Charge in hand, I don't want to use my last oil counter yet. Take those. Okay, on the draw, I think this is fine. Another blue. Man, it's always turn three Mantis. All Testament Bearer is good versus that, at least. Have any of our removal in our hand. Maybe I'm not supposed to block with that 1-1 there in case I draw Glare, but I have Scamp too for that, so I think I'm fine. Find a slash, easy. I don't want to play out my Furnace Strider and then them have like a predation or something off the top. That is a very fat boy. God, I want to move the litter over, but I think that's too risky. Then I'd have to like chump with my Furnace Strider or go to 9. The splitter here is going to be amazing versus that Paladin. Let's any of our creatures block it. All right, we're looking good. Go for lethal next turn. GG. Fine. Well, I was gonna equip with Scourge, equip the splitter to my scamp, and then shoot my scamp, but... that's more clicks. So we saw zero blue cards and just a lot of good green. Kind of terrifying. In fact, they only played one non-creature, and it was this card, which I don't think is all that good. Scamp out Duressin again. This hand's fine on the draw. Flash is good versus them, we know. We have a 2-drop, we have 17 lands. Wow, they had multiple Vorax last game. Damn, not doing anything that turn kind of sucks though. Ooh, but they played a tap land? Jeez. Honestly, that's probably game over right there with our hand. They play like a Tyrant Axe and we're just like, eh, one mana, kill it, draw three. Slightly annoying. But well worth rebuking for the seven. Feels pretty good to have a feed in hand as my last card. Well, this certainly makes me feel a little bit better about yesterday's fiascos. Let's keep it going. Even on the play, I would probably mulligan this. I can sack the splitter itself, but the engraver is probably not going to have too much utility beyond first few turns, I would guess. Probably too risky to let that live. So I'm going to tap out for Engraver, and then if they did something to it, that'd be pretty bad. Or they just like Flensing Raptor here, you know? Not bad for them to copy the chorus, because then if the 2-2 dies, they get a 1-1. It's pretty good. Ooh, that Red Sun's Twilight gonna be juicy. Only problem with this making this play is that spell bomb on my engraver equipped the Sinew Dancer, turned into a chorus, and now I'm toxicked or corrupted. So now they're only gonna have to pay one. Well, they're gonna have to pay two to move the equipment off first, but. Oh God. That's an annoying land for them to have drawn. I don't think I can go to 8. Poison, that is. I messed up, didn't I? This is a big punt. I lose. I'm dead on board. Whoops. I got scared of the poison, but now I lose to flyers. They can pump the chorus and then equip the chorus, turn it into a fissure. Oh, they missed it. Well, they can still equip one of their, Maybe they still miss it? Unlikely to, but I'm gonna need to draw, like, I don't even know. Ah, big mistake. Now wait just a gosh darn second. Oh, you know what? I should have attacked first. They probably would have blocked. Then I would have killed the 1-1 as well. Ah. Too many mistakes here. I needed to have bolt charged the fissure immediately. They missed it, and then... Yeah. Whoopsies. Alright, you got me. So play one Hive Master out, Volt Charge the Flyer. I still take a lot of damage. So I can only block one thing. That was winnable, most likely. Edict is pretty bad versus Chorus. Alright, let's tighten up. Need to draw land here real bad. Land might win the game immediately. Nice. I say win the game immediately, but obviously it doesn't win. Didn't actually expect them to block there. I couldn't move the equipment post. Since they had one damage on the edifice already. They have white for creatures, but they... Okay, well now they do. But they didn't have white for tricks. I'm happy to trade here though, or rather block if they do something. Don't need to show him the glider. Oh, now they're not dead. They can't double block. They do corrupt me if they want to, which of course there's no reason not to attack, but it's pretty bleak. Oh man, how many choruses do they have? Hopefully not more than those two, or if they do have more, hopefully they don't have them early. The Batterfists are also pretty awkward versus Chorus. We're going to need to mulligan to a low curve versus them. Our best turn two play is going to be Engraver. We're not bringing in Fusing, just a trade with half of Chorus. Charforger on threes like the nuts. I don't think I can keep this. First play is on turn three. That's so much better. That's really good. I'm going to lose the Batterfist here instead of the Strider. We have a better 2-2 drop on two. Let's say it's a 2-2 on two. Yep. Alright. So, running out the Slinger, I don't love it because we know they have a bunch of artifacts, but we just need to find a couple of our removal spells and we'll be okay. I brought in the Twilight. I mean, the Fissures are going to be the big problem. Good. ABA, always be attacking. Love that deal. They missed a land drop, right? So obviously they would like to draw a card there, but I'm okay with this. Oh, they missed again. I could free roll attack with the Charforger, but that's probably game over. Not necessarily, but looking pretty damn bad for them. Double block the Hive Master, I'll kill the Synthesizer. Now we can start attacking with our 1-1s. Charforger will get online for extra card advantage. Didn't see any retrofitters from them, but we have a way to deal with that. They need Mesmerizing Dose here, which we did see in the previous first game, I think. Boo, and this is just till the end of the turn. Yeah. That's a sick draw. Holy smokes. Well, there's the Dose. I don't know if they can realistically attack. No, those weren't good draws. I know I get corrupted here, but I don't think I have to, or I don't think I'm supposed to slash that. Oh, yikes. Okay. Top deck battle, and they do have the land for extra draw. Let's just draw our second Furnace Strider, please. Man, the feed was so good, and then... Oh, boy. That's good, but they get to bounce it for a turn. But that's a really good draw for us. That's also really freaking good. Looks like they did keep a land in their hand. Because they had priority last time. Okay, I mean... like, their play might be to equip the Might, make it a glider, and double block. Imagine being able to cast a 6-mana spell and a 4-mana spell. We have a second Strider that's 4 instant speed. We have a glider that's 4 instant speed. They might just use +2/+2 and save. That's fine. Oh, same thing. That's pretty gross. Ooh, let's get it, baby. All right, we are locked in for the second draft, no matter what happens. That is a delicious 3-0 start. All right. After all of the pain of yesterday, I should have around 80,000 gems, 78,000. I filed for reimbursement. I assume they'll give it to me because of the qualifier mishap. Well, rather, they messaged me saying they will give me the thing, but... They just messaged me again after I messaged saying I didn't get the gems. Thank you for contacting Wizards of the Coast support. Your records show that 4,000 gems were added to your account on March 5th, 2023 at 5:45 a.m. I assume today is March 5th or March 5th. But I have 74,680. Okay, when did I post on Twitter? I posted on Twitter. No, they're lying. Unless I... No, they're lying. I have a screenshot to prove it. I posted at 9:34 p.m. last night that I had 74,440 gems. The extra we have is just from, like, the rares and stuff. I did not get the refund. Or the reimbursement. Nice try. Gotta do some freaking detective work here. The Twitter timestamp was 9:34 p.m. March 4th. All right. See if that works. I posted last night on Twitter. I ended my 10 open tries with 74,440 gems or something at 9:34 p.m. I messaged them this morning saying, hey, could I get compensation because what I did was accidentally join the qualifier play-in last night thinking it was the open, and then I just immediately dropped. So I was down 4,000 gems. This morning, I reached out to them about it, saying, hey, can I get that compensation? They said, sure. Here are your 4,000 gems. I said, I don't see the gems added back to the account yet. Will they be granted later? They said, hello, blah, 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 thank you. It shows that 4,000 gems were added March 5th, 2023 at 5:45 a.m. That's not possible. I have proof. Give me my refund! That's a mulligan. There we go. I'm gonna pitch a land here. Nothing but ones and twos, so. There's merit to slashing this because then it lets our edict maybe get something better. Also edict still, because that's a token. Yeah, I kind of like trading here. Again, it makes my edict better. Both players red-black, both players on 2 mana. That's just magic, baby. Drew all my top end, that's good. Yeah, it's not the one we wanted to see. Alright, well. Somebody drew out of the screw and somebody didn't. 4 lands in a row? One time? That sucks. Obviously, I put a land on the bottom. I think it was 100% correct. I would do it again. The third land wouldn't have mattered all that much anyways, right? We wouldn't have even found a fourth by now, so. Good beats. Looks like it's just basically 100% Amir. Didn't see any duress hits, but the halberd. I don't know if we want to bring in the duresses. I think we'll just run it back and hope to not Matt Mulligan and screw. Good. I'm gonna have the same curve again, but this time I get to actually play magic. They're gonna go halberd turn two. Close enough. I don't think we have much reason to slash since we have such a good turn three play. Okay. I'll assume they have crescendo and then probably need to find a land. Lucky. Rin Twin, thanks for the 7 months. Is this going to be the opposite of game one? Miss your fourth land? Yeah. Oh, Chimney Rabble time. Hoth time! This doesn't hit Planeswalkers. That's bad. That's bad, baby. Well, you gotta do what you gotta do, and sometimes that's going to five. I'm expecting Furnace Daddy this turn. I'm gonna have to chump attack my Charforger into a Strider.
I'll never forget the home we lost.
Molten Rebuke off the top. Not much I can do here. Oof, they have anoint. Well, that's that, I guess. Got me. Oh, actually, no, wait, what? That doesn't kill me. They still need another creature. They have a land and one unknown, chat. Don't do it. Hold? So they don't have a creature in hand, or at least not a red creature. Rebuke off the top? One time? We actually had outs here. Not to kill them this turn, but... what can you do? Alright, GG's, presumably. Man, even just any random creature there would have been so good for probable double blocks on that thing. That is actually not bad. Oh my god, I'm one off lethal this turn. That is insane. I'm one off lethal. That is so sick. Oh well. We just needed a little bit more. That sucks.